这是巴斯卡的同期，我的老公。你好。是两届大学道的同牌活着人，法国队的。这位是我们大女孩，丹雅，今年刚刚18岁。然后我们小女孩米拉，4岁啊，你几岁，宝贝？4岁。然后我们小男孩，北京出生的，北京出生的艾莉，2岁的。要跳的ski？
你要去滑雪吗？
对。The first time was in 98 when I came here, living in the Hutong, which is Hutong still there. And at that time, I was just graduated from high school. And I wanted to start Chinese at university, but first I wanted to get a feeling of the country and the people. When I graduated from my master's degree, I joined the 2008 Olympic here in Beijing for the organizing committee. And since then, I have to say that I've always tried always to stay or come back.
Actually, I met my wife here in Beijing 2008. Summer Olympic, and I was an athlete. I was supposed to fight for the Olympics.
Pascal is a twice Olympic bronze medalist in Taekwondo France, and so he was also participating to the 2028 Games. And at that time, I was already working for the organizing committee, and so basically that's how our story began. In 2008, I was managing a team of French-speaking translators. So it was a completely different job. For this Winter Games, I'm in charge of relations with the European delegations.
So basically we have an individual meeting with them to make sure that they have all the details they need.
这个是我最难忘意的一个时刻，就那时候是2年前正好在春节这个期待，习主席来访的我们组委会的。 然后我不但见到他，我还给他握手了，和给他说了几句中文的，真的不可思议的。新年快乐！新年快乐！
When China win the bid for Beijing 2022, we move back to China in January 2018, and now we are living here.
我们承办北京冬奥会后巴黎奥运会还有2年的承办工作。 我还可以回国继续为我的祖国、为奥运做贡献，但是更重要的是，我诚信中法之前两个国家可以贡献很多奥运会方面的经验。我致力于成为中国交流的纽带。 奥运会的可持续的最核心的还是奥运会有激励下一代的力量。一方面给专业运动员创造经济体育的平台，更重要的一方面也是激发普通老百姓能参与体育的热情，全面培养下一代的在日常生活中真正的参与到体育的习惯。